Hi everyone, in this video I will show you how to install ESP32 in Arduino IDE. Before installing ESP32 in Arduino IDE, you need to make sure you are using a latest version of Arduino IDE because ESP32 has issues with previous versions of Arduino IDE. After installing latest version of Arduino IDE, go to Files and click on Preferences. In Preferences, you will find option of additional board manager URLs. You need to paste this URL here. This URL basically a package of ESP32. If you are using other URLs also, you can simply separate them by commas and paste as many URLs you want. For example, if you are using ESP8266, you have already pasted a URL of ESP8266 here, but if you are using ESP32 only, you can paste this URL. For multiple URLs, you can separate them by commas. After that, click on OK. Now you need to install the library of ESP32. To install the library of ESP32, go to Tools, go to Boards, and click on Board Manager. Now to install ESP32, you need to search for ESP32. To search ESP32, click write ESP32 here, and you will find this option of ESP32 by Expressive Systems. I have already installed it, but when you search it ESP32, you will find the option of install. You simply need to click on install and wait for a few seconds. It will be installed automatically, and you will not find any issues with the installation. After installation, you need to check either you have installed ESP32 library successfully or not. You can simply test it. You test it, you need to open an example. But before opening an example, you need to select the ESP32 board you are using. For example, in this tutorial, I am using ESP32 dev kit. So I will select, go to board, and select ESP32 dev kit. Here you can see ESP32 dev module. But there are many types of ESP32 development boards available in market, so you can select any ESP32 board you want. For example, if you are using ESP32 Pico kit, you need to select this, and there are many options available here. But I am using ESP32 dev kit, so I will select ESP32 dev module. After that, you need to select the port to which your board is connected. To select it, go to Tools and click on Port and select COM5. And you need to select the COM to which your board is connected. For example, in my case, it is connected with COM pin 5. Now go to Files and go to Examples. Now find the examples of ESP32. These are the examples for ESP32. Go to Wi-Fi and click on Wi-Fi scan. In this example, what this example will do, it will search for the available networks in my area, and it will simply print the name of those networks on serial monitor. You don't need to worry about the programming right now, because I will discuss programming in later sections of these tutorials. So now simply click on upload button to upload code to ESP32. If you find any issue while uploading code to ESP32, you can press the button of boot on your ESP32 board, which is available on ESP32 dev kit, but such type of errors usually do not occur. But if you find any error, you can push the button off, or you can hold the button of boot, and after that you can click the button of upload to upload code. Now simply click on upload. It will take some time to upload the code. You need to make sure you have selected proper port number and board. It will compile the code and upload it to ESP32 board. As you can see, it is uploading code to ES32 board. Code has been uploaded successfully. Now go to Tools and click on Serial Monitor. As you can see, you're getting an option of Scan Start, Scan Done, and it is displaying two networks shown, VTCL-BB and another one is Charo. So this is how you can test it, either you have successfully installed ESP32 or not. Okay, in the next video I will show you how to use general purpose input output pins of ESP32 board.